Kanye West's 2010 album, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, is considered by many to be one of the greatest musical works of all time. With 13 tracks, Yeezy's magnum opus pushed the boundaries of hip-hop and redeemed Kanye in the eyes of fans and critics alike after a series of controversies. Ye's prior solo efforts already established him as a genre-defining musician, notably selling out stadiums with Graduation and shifting rap sound with 808s and Heartbreak. But on My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, West interrogated this fame and celebrity as previous works had brought him from the position of a castaway.
Yo, Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish. But Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time. One of the best videos of all time.
Kanye's interruption of Taylor Swift at the 2009 MTV Video Music Awards is set in motion a fierce backlash that reached even the highest levels of the U.S. government.
The young lady seems like a perfectly nice person. She's getting her award. What's he doing up there?
Why would he do
that? He's a jackass.
Kanye apologized a few days later, but widespread anger and a canceled tour with Lady Gaga forced him into self-exile. After this hiatus, Kanye left to Hawaii with a slew of producers, comedians, rappers, and more for what was deemed rap camp.
Like, literally left America. I stopped doing music altogether. When I came back to the States, I moved to Hawaii and lived there.
Wow.
Lived there for like 6 months and just worked on music again.
Pete Rock, the RZA.
Oh, you went back to the essence.
Yes.
Yeah. People with that intangible sound, the people that everybody copied.
The way everything happened, though, was like focus energy, yo. And actually, I never seen that from a rapper before.
Legendary Queens rapper Q-Tip described the process as communal, saying, quote, "It was like music by committee. If the delivery guy comes in the studio and Kanye likes him and they strike up a conversation, he'll go, check this out, tell me what you think."
I really put myself in a zone that I felt like my life was dependent on the success of this album.
Ye's musical return came in late May 2010 with his lead single, Power, where he pushed back on the limitations of fame as a black man.
"In this white man world, we the ones chosen. So good night, cool world, I see you in the morning."
Explained his absence.
"I just needed time alone with my own thoughts. Got treasures in my mind, but couldn't open up my own vault. My talent, like creativity, purity, and honesty is honestly being crowded by these grown thoughts."
And grappled with being rebuked by the U.S. and its first black president.
"Powers, Austin, powers, lost in translation with a whole fucking nation. They say I was the Obama nation of Obama's nation. Well, that's a pretty bad way to start the conversation."
The music video cast Ye as a god, something he would later embody on 2013's Yeezus. Ye was determined to use free music to get back in the good graces of pop culture. Starting in August 2010 and running 15 weeks up until the release, Kanye began Good Fridays, dropping a new track every week for free. The second week featured a posse cut called Monster, featuring Jay-Z, Rick Ross, and Bon Iver, with a standout verse from then upstart Nicki Minaj.
Pink wig, thick ass, give them whiplash. I think big, get cash, make them blink fast. Now look at what you just saw, this is what you live for. I'm a motherfucking monster.
In an interview, Nicki told Genius's Rob Markman that the verse was so wild, it almost didn't even make the album.
"I remember Kanye called me and he said, I know this is good. I know niggas is gonna say this is the best verse of my album. I'm taking a chance by putting this shit on here, man. You know what I'm saying?"
Good Fridays changed the landscape for building hype. Similar to the free mixtapes popularized by 50 Cent and Lil Wayne back in the mid to late aughts, Good Fridays kept hip-hop fans tuned in for each weekly drop. But in order to get pop culture back, he would have to return to the mantle he fell from. The MTV VMAs. Kanye's September 2010 return to the VMA stage came with his song Runaway, an explicit backhanded apology for the controversy he caused the year prior.
"Let's have a toast for the douchebags. Let's have a toast for the assholes. Let's have a toast for the scumbags. Everyone in them that I know."
West never planned on seriously apologizing for something he felt was true.
"I feel like in some ways, like I'm a soldier of culture. And I realized that no one wants that to be my job. And I'll never go on stage again. I'll never sit in an award show again. But will I feel convicted about things that really meant stuff to culture that constantly get denied for years and years and years and years? I'm sorry. I will."
And to this day, Kanye West and Taylor Swift remain at odds. Runaway also contained a scathing verse from good music label mate Pusha T.
"Every bag, every blouse, every bracelet comes with a price tag, baby, face it. You should leave if you can't
except the basics. Plenty holes in a ball of nigga matrix. Invisibly set, the Rolex is faceless. I'm just young, rich, and tasteless. P.
That October, West revealed My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy as the album's title and announced a new film called Runaway. According to West, the film was a quote, parallel to my career. I threw a Molotov cocktail in my career last year in a way, and I had to come back as a better person.
The main meaning of the film is just express yourself and don't let people tell you how to think or how to be.
On November 22nd, 2010, Kanye West's My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy was released and was instantly met with critical acclaim. The album opens with Nicki Minaj in a faux British accent reading a spin on a passage from Roald Dahl's 1982 piece Revolting Rhymes.
You might think you've peeped the scene. You haven't. The real one's far too mean. The watered-down one, the one you know, was made up centuries ago.
Ye's first words on the project speak to achieving his dreams of success.
I fantasize about this back in Chicago. Mercy, mercy me, that mercy will I go. That's me, the first year that I blow. How you say broke in Spanish, me no I blow.
The second track, Gorgeous, features seminal verses from Ye as he critiques how harsh mistakes are for black men in America, notably himself.
Inner century anthems based off inner city tantrums, based off the way we was branded. Face it, Jerome get more time than Brandon. And at the airport, they check all through my bag and tell me that it's random.
Kid Cudi struck a chord singing on the hook.
Ain't no question if I want it, I need it. I can feel it slowly drifting away from me. I'm on the edge, so why you playing? I'm saying I will never, ever let you live this down, down, down.
The album's early peak can be heard on its fifth song, All of the Lights, a wide-ranging collaboration featuring more than a half dozen additional voices, including Sir Elton John.
12 people on that song because I couldn't find the answer. Dream, Elton John, Rihanna, Drake, Kid Cudi, Fergie, so many people, Q-Tip, worked on this song until we found the answer. In my opinion, one of my greatest sonic landscapes.
Soul Pult also includes one of Yeezy's earliest mentions of President Donald Trump, who Ye aligned himself with in late 2016.
I'm so tall, spawning, Donald Trump taking dollars from y'all.
On Devil in a New Dress, Rick Ross delivers a career verse after an extended guitar interlude from legendary producer Mike Dean.
Getting Tupac money twice over, still a real nigga, red coochie sweater, dice roller. I'm making love to the angel of death. Catch your feelings, never stumble, retracing my steps.
Dark Fantasy's apex is Blame Game featuring John Legend. On the song, Ye reminisces about the end of a rocky relationship.
All of the lies, it was called the hype, girl, and I was satisfied being in love with the lie.
Who to blame, you to blame,
me to blame
for the pain it be pouring every time when it rains.
Let's play the blame game.
And that song ends with a legendary sketch from Chris Rock.
Yo, this is the best birthday ever. Where you learn to treat a nigga like this?
Yeezy taught me.
Kanye West is a genius. I'm gonna say I was in the booth for about 2 hours.
Oh my God, I thought it was just like a one take.
No, man, he was just throwing shit at me and try this, try that.
Many thought the song was about his ex-girlfriend Amber Rose, but she doesn't buy it.
It just didn't pertain to me personally, so that everyone else thought it was just about me, and it wasn't.
The last song in the album is the Bon Iver-assisted Lost in the World, where Ye speaks to his now wife, Kim Kardashian West.
Lost in the World, I wrote like this poem to her, and it ended up being the lyrics for Lost in the World.
You're my devil, you're my angel, you're my heaven, you're my hell, you're my now, you're my forever, you're my freedom, you're my jail.
The album ends with the late poet Gil Scott Heron's piece Comment Number One for the track Who Will Survive in America.
Who will survive in America? Who will survive in America? Who will survive in America? Who will survive in America?
My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy went on to sell nearly 500,000 records in its first week and is now certified 2x platinum. While not as plainly influential as his fourth album, 808s and Heartbreak, Dark Fantasy is seen by some as Kanye's magnum opus. Ye wanted back into the spotlight and did it the only way he knew how, making great music. And it's something he first saw on Last Call off of 2004's College Dropout.
Now I can let these dream killers kill my self-esteem. I use my arrogance as a steam to power my dreams.
In order to survive, Yeezy had to give it his all and show everyone who Kanye West really was. I'm Jacques Morel with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music. At home. Peace.